Okay. Hi all, this is Vinod. This is class one. And now in case if you want to create your own project on face recognition using deep learning. Yeah, so you can watch my video and you can also refer to the below given URL for more information. And you can also give me a call back on this number in case you need any help. And I also request you to please like and subscribe my videos. Yeah, let's understand how we can create our own face recognition project using deep learning. Now talking about some of the requirement for building this face recognition. So we would be using OpenCV, a library, Python, and deep learning methods. Yeah, so these gonna be our requirement for building our face recognition project. Now talking about deep learning, yeah. So once we combine the deep learning with face recognition technique, we call this as deep metric learning. Yeah, we'll talk about what deep learning is, what methods we use in deep learning, and how do we apply the face recognition techniques. But as of now, once you combine these two, deep learning and face recognition, we call this as deep metric learning. Yeah. Let's understand this. So let's say this is your neural network, so you pass on your image that you want to recognize face on. So that becomes input to our neural network, right? And this neural network we use to classify this image. I want to label this image, yeah. And we, for this network, we use the DLib, facial network, facial recognition network, right? So it's a deep learning based model or network. What it does basically, once you supply an image to this model, it gives you a real value feature vector, which is nothing but a 128 numerical values, right? And this technique, we call it as a deep metric learning. Right. So once we apply deep learning along with the face recognition, so eventually you should be getting a feature vector having 128 numerical values after applying the DLib facial recognition network. Let's go further. So for this, what we do, apply the triplet techniques. So what is the triplet techniques? So in our network, neural networks, we supply three images. One image is of another person and two images of the same person but with slight variation, right? So these three images we supply to our network for training. Let's say this image is of Chad Smith, right? And once we pass on this image to our neural networks, we get 128 numerical values. We call it as a measurement, which is generated by our neural network. Likewise, for these two images, which of the same person, Will Ferrell, we supply these two images to our neural network and we also get the same 128 numerical measurement values, right? Now these three we compare, right? And while comparing, we tweak the weights in our neural network so that these two images of Will Ferrell are closer. And the image of the Chad Smith is further away. So we keep on tweaking our weights so that these two images are closer in distance, and this picture of Chad Smith is far away. Yeah? So that's how we apply the triplet technique. Let's go further. Now, if we understand about deep learning method, so this network, this neural network architecture is based on RSNet34 from the Deep Residual Learning for Image Recognition, which is a paper published by et al. Yeah. So if somebody asks you, what is the network architecture? So you can say it's based on RSNet34 from the Deep Residual Learning for Image Recognition. Yeah. Davis King. So Davis King is the creator of DLib module that we would be using for face embeddings. Face embeddings is nothing but, you know, generating those 128 numerical values for you know, for face recognition. So DLib module will help you, you know, to create those face embeddings. And this has been, you know, this has been created by Davis King. So he's the creator for this module. Now Adam Gidgey, he's the creator of face recognition module. That is nothing but a wrapper around this DLib module, you know, which makes it easier for this program to work. So that's all about for today. We'll continue talking more about deep learning method. We'll do a practical session as well. So please stay tuned to my videos. And thank you so much for watching this. Once again, I request you to please like and subscribe to my videos. Thank you.